It is with great pleasure that I introduce tonight's student speaker, Ms. Heidi Garcia. Heidi came to the United States from Panama 4 years ago. She enrolled at Copper Mountain College, where she took classes to improve her English and eventually enroll in the nursing program. I now present to you Ms. Heidi Garcia.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, professor, special guests, students, families, and friends. My name is Heidi Garcia. I am a student here at Copper Mountain College. When I first joined Copper Mountain College, I started in English as a second language with little knowledge of English. My angel was Professor Antonella Bonet, whose unconditional support helped me and encouraged me to enroll to take regular classes. She was my guide and my mentor here at Copper Mountain College. I am from Panama, and our primary language is Spanish. I moved here 4 years ago with almost no English language experience. I was very afraid when I enrolled in regular classes with native English speaker. Many times I was embarrassed to speak to them, and I always had trouble understanding them. I never thought I would finish a degree here, much less English classes. When I finished the classes, I came back to Professor Antonietta, and I told her I already finished all the English class, but I didn't feel like I knew English. She told me to enroll in different classes which were to help me with conversational English. I never thought I would understand the English language and complete a degree in the process. I was like Americans say, a fish out of water. I was scared. I have a background in psychology in Panama, so I thought I would enroll in classes like psychology or anatomy to help me obtain my knowledge. I did not stop studying and taking different classes. I heard about the nursing program and I said to myself, nurse? No, I cannot deal with blood. But that option was on my mind for a while. I had an appointment with my counselor, Mrs. Andrea, and I asked her for information about the nursing program. She told me that I have everything but pharmacology to complete all the prerequisites to apply to the nursing program. So I enrolled. I heard a lot of negatives, like nursing is really hard and a lot of students apply, but only some are selected. When the time came, I talked with my mentor and she told me I could do it. I decided to apply and I was so happy when I was accepted, especially when I heard that a lot of students tried to get into the program. My first reaction was, thank God. Nursing was really hard for me. I learned so much in this journey that was full of ups and downs, but every single part of it was worth it. I will not shake a single thing from my experience in this program. I reached a spread level I never, ever knew I was capable of reaching. I could reach and now believe I'm capable of way more than I thought I was before entering in this program. I always try my hardest and get my all in everything, despite my difficulty with the English language. Nothing got in between me and my goals. I learned from every mistake I made. At the end of the day, the experience is something I will always remember. One more time, thank you, Copper Mountain College, for all your support. It was really hard, but not impossible. A lot of nights without sleep, a lot of crying, thinking that I have enough and wanting to quit. Fortunately, Copper Mountain College has very professionals and wonderful professors like Glenda Case, Paul Delaney, Tania Queen, and Kathleen Wall, who always care about students. students to serve and support me in my journey. I also want to thank the amazing Duros for the help and encouragement. The Copper Mountain College staff is amazing, always caring for student comfort and need. I can't believe that I'm here with all these amazing professional classmates and supporting families. But no more supporting than my family I have at home. To my son Eduardo, who also graduated today. I'm very proud of you and your accomplishment. To my daughters, Allison and Melanie, you are my inspiration. Copper Mountain College is something that we already did with me. In the last year of this program, my fellow nursing student and I learned a lot about expert system. We go together for almost every day. We all learn a lot from each other and for 18. After being with the same people for 40 or more hours a week, it brought us closer. Every lunch together, a study group, even some weekends. All of it will always be part of us and who we have become. Each one of us will always be grateful for those memories, good and bad. It's what all work is at the end. We should work together and can accomplish anything we set in our minds too, no matter what barrier is in our way. To my classmates, my goal is with you as you start or continue your professional career, and know that this is just the beginning of the rewarding career as health care professional. It was very difficult, but we did it. I never could have accomplished it without all the support and positive people that always believe in me and encourage me. Thank you.
Thank you, Heidi, for an outstanding testimonial. We extend to you our best wishes for the future. Now I have the great pleasure of introducing to you our commencement keynote speaker, a true friend and supporter of education and Copper Mountain College, Dr. Sharon Brown-Welty. Dr. Brown-Welty was appointed Dean of Cal State San Bernardino's Palm Desert campus in July of 2014, where she oversees the operations of a university campus. In her capacity as Dean, she is responsible for the academic offerings, student life programs, community outreach and fundraising, and general administration and operations of the campus. Since her appointment as Dean, she has chaired the One Futures Committee on Education, College Access and Completion, and the Committee for Successful Transitions. She serves on numerous boards throughout the Greater Palm Springs area, including committees of the Clinton Health Matters Initiative. Previous to her appointment as Dean at CSUSB Palm Desert, Dr. Brown-Welty served in a number of positions at Fresno State University, including Dean of Graduate Studies, Director of Doctoral Program in Educational Leadership, Department Chair of Education Research and Administration, and Associate Vice President of Academic Affairs. Prior to arriving at Fresno State, she served at Indiana University of Pennsylvania as the Assistant Provost, the Interim Associate Provost, and the Assistant to the Vice President of Finance. Dr. Brown-Welty is the author of a number of book chapters on educational leadership and has served as an editor and reviewer of professional education publications. Recent awards include the Outstanding Educator and Inductee into the Rotary Education Hall of Fame in 2016, the 2016 Impact Award by the SBEMP Law Firm in Palm Springs, and she was selected as the 2017 Education Leader by the Palm Springs Women's Leadership Forum. Dr. Brown-Welty has a bachelor's and a master's degree in business administration from Indiana University of Pennsylvania and an educational doctorate in higher education administration and policy studies from the University of Pittsburgh. She is married to Dr. John Welty, President Emeritus, Fresno State University, and together they have 5 children and 6 grandchildren. It is my honor to present tonight's keynote speaker, Dr. Sharon Brown-Welty, Dean of Cal State San Bernardino's Palm Desert campus.
Thank you for that wonderful introduction. Trustees, President, Superintendent Cummings, faculty, administration, graduates, parents, and friends, I'm honored to be here today to congratulate you on your current achievement, graduating from Copper Mountain Community College. Graduations are a joyous occasion. Why? Because you have worked hard and reached a goal. You have reached the light at the end of the tunnel, and you can now see the light at the end of the next tunnel. You are among the elite group of graduates. Did you know that in California, only 30% of community college attendees actually graduate with their associate's degree or transfer to a four-year university? Only 30%. That means that 70% of students who started an associate's degree did not make it to that light at the end of the tunnel. You are indeed a special group of people. I mentioned earlier that you can see the light at the end of the next tunnel. Did you catch that? But why did I say that? Because you now need to begin working on your bachelor's degree. According to the Public Policy Institute of California, California will continue to need greater numbers of workers with bachelor's degrees. In 2030, and that's not that far away, they are projecting only 33% of the California workforce will hold a bachelor's degree. And there will be a shortfall of 1.1 million college graduates to fill the available jobs. Let me repeat that. By the year 2030, there will be a shortfall of 1.1 million college graduates with a bachelor's degree in California that will be necessary to fill available jobs. We are all counting on associate degree holders like yourselves to go that next step and get your bachelor's degree so that this prediction does not come true. As I mentioned, you have now reached the point where if you haven't done so already, it's time to plan for your next goal in life. And as you prepare to make these plans, I would like to offer you three pieces of advice. First, say thank you to everyone who helped get you here today. That includes faculty, parents, partners, friends, and family members. These two words are very powerful words because they have an impact on the person who says the words as well as on the person to whom they are said. Yes, they have an impact on those who speak the words. Consider this. Saying thank you shows gratitude and humility. It acknowledges that we need others to accomplish our dreams. Saying thank you demonstrates compassion, kindness, and love. It is a memory from the heart. You remember the kindness of others through your heartfelt gratitude, through those two words. Research by Robert Emmons in 2007 found that grateful people experience higher levels of positive emotions, such as joy, enthusiasm, love, happiness, and optimism, and that the practice of gratitude, or saying thank you, protects a person from the destructive impulses of envy, resentment, greed, and bitterness. In addition, a person who experiences gratitude is able to cope more effectively with stress. Increased feelings of connectedness have improved relationships and altruism, and all this from saying thank you. Lastly, thank you connects us with the goodness in others. According to Voltaire, appreciation is a wonderful thing. It makes what is excellent in others belong to us as well. So say thank you often. Second, make a life plan and work hard to achieve it. Do you go on trips to new destinations without a roadmap? So why is life any different? Life is a new destination, and you can get lost very easily along the way without a plan or a map. If you want to get somewhere in life and not wander aimlessly from week to week, month to month, year to year, have a written plan. And remember, detours can be an adventure and plans can be changed to meet new goals and priorities. A life plan will help you say no to activities that don't really matter. A plan will give you clarity about what is meaningful in your life. And lastly, having a plan to help you navigate your life will ensure that at the end of your life, you will not have regrets. Be sure your plan includes getting that bachelor's degree as well as lifelong learning, whatever that looks like for you. Third, be a positive force in the world. I know you will agree that there is so much negativity going on in the world today that being a positive force is difficult. The news, the social media outlets, they open us all to a whole world of negativity. Who would have ever guessed that the trolls that used to live under the bridge now live in social media, and many of us see them every day? With all this negativity, how can we be a positive force? It is simple, really. Here are a few ways to consider. First and foremost, stay away from the negativity. Shut down those media sources that bring you down and bring others down. Build positive daily habits and routines. Read to learn about changes and breakthroughs in your career that will build you to your full potential. Say kind things every day to those you work with, play with, and live with. That bears repeating. Say kind words every day to those you work with, play with, and live with. Perform acts of kindness whenever possible, and even pay it forward when you can. When is the last time you bought the person behind you in line a cup of coffee? Use everyday language that fosters positivity and empowers you. I can. I will find out how. I will. Those are the words that need to be part of your vocabulary register to be used every day. Go the extra mile. Do more than you agreed to do and do it smiling. Serve others. Volunteer whenever you can. Come back to this community college, the Copper Mountain College, and tutor. Mentor or whatever is needed here. Be an outstanding alum in every way. Encourage those around you to get their degrees, just like you. Lastly, pick yourself up when you fall down and be self-compassionate. Treat yourself like you would treat your best friend and move on when something did not turn out the way you hoped it would. Remember, it isn't important how many times you fall down. What is important is how many times you get back up. If you do these simple things, you will help move the world around you into a more positive upward spiral, and you will have a positive impact on those with whom you interact. In conclusion, you have accomplished one important goal with your graduation today, and now you are ready to move to the next phase of your life and your next set of goals and plans. Be outstanding alumni. Remember, you represent your college in your actions, and people are watching. Give back to your college when and how you can. Be a role model for those who come after you. Others really are watching you. Congratulations and best wishes for what your future holds for you. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Brown-Welty. We're so happy that you could be with us this evening. Thank you. At this time, I would again like to acknowledge Mr. David Shook. David will be announcing our graduates this evening. Board President Meyer, will you please come forward and join me at the podium? It gives me great pleasure to report to you that the graduates here this evening have met the requirements for degrees they are about to receive.
By the power vested in me by the State of California and the Board of Trustees of Copper Mountain College, I hereby confer upon you the degrees for which you have duly completed all requirements.
students graduating with their associate degrees from Copper Mountain College. Students, please rise and come forward to begin the procession of graduates and conferring of degrees.
Sociology and highest honors, Shelley Elaine Fee. With a degree in psychology with academic distinction, Brianna Marie Joy Talbert. With a degree in liberal arts, social and behavioral sciences, Lacey Jeanette Chenet. With a degree in administration of justice with high honors, Virginia Marie Lowell. Degree in liberal arts, mathematics and science, Luzelena Barba. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics and science, Vanessa Gabriela Valle. With a degree in criminal justice and high honors, Jessica Kuna Moncada. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics and science, Natasha Acosta. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Candace Law. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Natasha Neiman. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Jane Sudler.
Tasha.
With degrees in liberal arts, social and behavioral sciences, and sociology, Nina Pilar Jimenez. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Serena Pankhurst. With degrees in administration of justice, criminal justice, liberal arts, social and behavioral sciences, Ariana Rodriguez. With a degree in liberal arts, social and behavioral sciences, Sheila Christine Tabucci. Graduating with high honors, liberal arts, social and behavioral sciences, Hannah Lynn King. Graduating with high honors in early childhood education, Paige Elaine McClenathan. graduating in early childhood education, Carla Liliana Duarte. With a degree in computer science, Vanessa Elena Lopez. With degrees in liberal arts, mathematics and science, and psychology, Katrina S. Duham. With degrees in business administration and liberal arts, mathematics and science, Victoria Alexis Ramirez. Graduating with a degree in elementary teacher education, Isabel Andablo. With a degree in liberal arts, social behavioral sciences, Diane Marie Durden. Graduating with a degree in history, Alyssa Christine Roberson. Degrees in sociology and psychology, Michaela Sue Ellison. With a degree in psychology, Maria Lourdes Camacho Sloan. Graduating with academic distinction, liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Monique Cardenas. Graduating with academic distinction with liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Lindsay Darst. Graduating with academic distinction, liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Tamberlyn Russell. Graduating with a degree in Spanish, Lori Sarah Riskin Griffin. Graduating with a degree in general business, Mary K. Buckley. Graduating with highest honors in computer programming, Jeremy De Los Rios. Graduating with a degree in fire technology, Chantil Francis Nazario. Graduating with degrees in child development and early childhood education, Tasha Leanne Campbell. Graduating with a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Kennedy Lee Muertes. Graduating with academic distinction, liberal arts, social and behavioral sciences, Mary Michelle Stuckey. Graduating with academic distinction in business administration, Jerilyn Dong Funta. Graduating graduating with a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Sarah Naomi Lopez. Graduating with highest honors in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Candace Lauren Tausler. With a degree in business administration, Chris William Klevick. Graduating with a degree in registered nursing, Amber N. Fernandez. Graduating with academic distinction in registered nursing, Charles Michael Sanders. Graduating with highest honors in registered nursing, Ashley Alvarez. Graduating with a degree in registered nursing, Shelley L. Henderson. With a degree in registered nursing, Stephanie Nicole Breed. With a degree in registered nursing, Maria Carrillo Castro. With degrees in administration of justice and criminal justice, Gary Bronco. Graduating with high honors in computer information systems, Desiree Nicole McClellan. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Jacob Frank Edling. Graduating with a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Karina Venegas. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Ashley Lauren Ayala. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Kiana Michelle Mohit. Graduating with highest honors in business administration, Carrie East. With academic distinction and a degree in business administration, Megan Paige Smith. With a degree in registered nursing, Oscar Ramon Rico. With a degree in registered nursing, Alan Leon Mojica. With a degree in vocational nursing, Nadine Andrea Young. With a degree in vocational nursing, Jocelyn Jimenez Tirado. With a degree in vocational nursing, Nicole Hoover. graduating with academic distinction with a degree in vocational nursing, Aileen Brianna Tapia. With a degree in vocational nursing, Sulema Pimenta. With a degree in sociology, Eduardo Enrique Basile. With a degree in liberal arts, social and behavioral sciences, Cassandra Gray Connor. Graduating with academic distinction and a degree in psychology, Brandy Clayton. Graduating with high honors, with a degrees in computer programming and computer science, Lawrence Dumbrique Oriula. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Caleb Thomas Zietz. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Shaitan Sanjay Patel. Graduating with academic distinction with degrees in administration of justice and criminal justice, Santiago Castro. Graduating with a degree in history, Elizabeth Grace Schmeling. Graduating with highest honors with a degree in English, Colby Compton. Graduating with academic distinction and a degree in general business, James R. Richardson. With a degree in computer information systems, Robert John Byrne. Distinction and a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Gabriel Mikaya Royds. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Tyler N. Johnson. Graduating with academic distinction in computer programming, David Allen Patterson. Graduating with academic distinction and degrees in computer programming, computer science, and mathematics, Tyler Gary Gall. With a degree in computer information systems, Nathan Thomas Henry. With a degree in liberal arts, arts and humanities, Melissa Ann Howell. Graduating with high honors and degrees in administration of justice, liberal arts, social and behavioral sciences, Heather Lovejoy. graduating with academic distinction and a degree in fire technology, Dustin Scott Sundahl. Graduating with a degree in communication studies, Sierra Ann Zartler. With a degree in communication studies, Riley Ann O'Brien. With a degree in communication studies, David Mark Champagne. Graduating with high honors in computer programming, Michelle Elizabeth Granton. Graduating with academic distinction and a degree in psychology, Nicole A. White. Graduating with academic distinction and a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Jennifer Lynn Lukovich. With a degree in liberal arts, arts and humanities, Shiloh Rumer Lee Moore.
We love you, man.
Graduating with highest honors in a degree in anthropology, Kylie Jane Nicole Howell. With a degree in computer science, Tyler Allen Evans. With a degree in psychology, Joshua Russell Torres. Graduating with academic distinction and degrees in political science and liberal arts, social and behavioral sciences, Bernard James McFadden. With academic distinction and a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Danielle Lee Allen. With degrees in computer science, liberal arts, mathematics, and science, and mathematics, Dylan Michael Brentner. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Cody J. Kaufman. With a degree in computer information systems, Nathan A. Blanton. With a degree in liberal arts, arts and humanities, and basketball, Stephen McNeese. With a degree degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science. Erica Ludovina Gonzalez. Graduating with degrees in elementary teacher education and liberal studies for elementary school preparation to CSUSB, Sarah Gutierrez Hernandez. With degrees in elementary teacher education and liberal arts global studies for elementary school preparation to CSUSB, Destiny Marie Zuniga. With degrees in child development and early childhood education, Martha Shiraz. With a degree in business administration, Janet Nagayan Garcia. With a degree in liberal arts, arts and humanities, Brittany Johnson. With a degree in business administration, Brianna Monet Johnson. With degrees in criminal justice and psychology, Sonic Brown. With degrees in liberal arts, social and behavioral sciences, and psychology, Katarina Lujan Romero. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Robert Miller. with a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, James Richard Padilla. Graduating with academic distinction, with a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Carson Marie Skaczionowski. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Ariana Marie Gamboa. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Talia Olmsted. With a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Apasiwa Venora Pele. Graduating with academic distinction, with a degree in mathematics, Jonas William Esquire. Graduating with highest honors and a degree in administration of justice, Nicholas James Holtz. Graduating with academic distinction in a degree in liberal arts, mathematics, and science, Adrian Danielle Miller. Graduating with academic distinction in a degree in vocational nursing, Heidi Bertina Garcia.
Open so as to not block the recessional by faculty and students. Thank you for your attendance and participation in this significant occasion. Members of the Board of Trustees, family, friends, faculty, and staff, as Superintendent President, I am honored to present to you the 2018 graduating class of Copper Mountain College.
Thank you.